Hurricane Ian left our waterways littered with all kinds of debris, from cars to homes. This is what Estero Bay looked like exactly 1 month ago. You can see an entire house is almost underwater. Now, this is what it looks like now. Cleanup crews are working hard to clear mangroves and waterways across Estero Bay. Thanks for counting on NBC2 tonight. I'm Kyla Gaylor.
And I'm Peter Bush. Tonight, only NBC2's Gage Golden got a tour with the man leading the cleanup effort to see what kind of progress has been made.
Cleanup in our waterways here on Bonita Beach is evident. If you take a look right here, when we were here a month ago, there was actually a trailer stacked where you see all these dead mangroves. Now, it's removed, and the healing process can begin.
It's been a big change for me from when I saw it the day after.
Just take this stretch of mangroves, for example. This is from November 14th. Fast forward 1 month, and it looks like this. Crews with County Waste Incorporated are tasked with dealing with the debris, using giant claws and even their own two hands.
And they were going 20, 30 yards in and pulling out debris.
They've been out here for a little over a month now, piling just about anything they could find on these boats.
Right now, we're right at about 50,000 cubic yards of debris that's been taken out of the waterways.
That doesn't even include vehicles or vessels. Kevin Guthrie with the Florida Division of Emergency Management says there are roughly 3,000 of those in waters throughout Southwest Florida. Just like this one sitting in the bay. They're working on hauling these out, too.
I believe we're just shy of 100. Of those.
One example sticks out more than most. Remember that house that somehow made its way into the bay? Well, it's gone now. Where it once stood looks like it's nearly normal again. But there are some hurdles ahead.
It's going to be a slow, tedious process.
Currents in the water are filling areas they just cleaned up, meaning
we may end up revisiting the same place multiple times.
But Donna Schwinghammer says that's okay. She's just celebrating the little wins.
Just today, they made a lot of progress.
Every day, it's a little bit better.
I'm reporting local tonight on Bonita Beach. Gage Golding, NBC2.